Hey guys, welcome to match two for the semi-finals of the upper bracket of the World of War tournament, 2v2 tournament, and we are here to see the allies, European gentlemen, Framas as French, France, interesting pick, and Nat as Soviets, and Axis, Jutska as Japan, and Gora de Elba Schotter as Germany, and they are catch my N. So I'll take the fog of war. Enough. Wow. Rush by from Jitsuka. Going to type 92. See what happens. He's going to just go around hoping to find a squad in the open. He's shooting blankly with direct control. Let's follow this all around. See how this goes. All weaving through the bushes. No. Oh, awkward driving by the AI right there. And is in an awkward position right now. And I think Framas does notice he's forced to move his squad back. He's sending one SMG guy alone. But has totally stopped the cap. Has totally stopped them from moving forward, as you can see. And that some elite marksmen pushing up very, very frontally. As the other end, we have Nat in the open by himself. No one capping because Jutska's bought this Type 92. But I think that's where he's going now. He's going to try to clean up, but needs some line of sight. Schotter, or Jutska, is going to move up some guys singly to have a look. Framas opening up on the other side quite well, taking out three of Jutska's troops, and Schotter's troops, and another 4-0 right now. Schotter has taken him out though. But here is the Type 92. Gonna try to claim its first target. Definitely, I think, a failed opening by Team Catch My End. And they're going to lose. Oh no. They've actually capped most of the flags from that. But 4-1, they've definitely made losses. A lot more losses than the other team. Oh. No, they've lost the center mid, and Catch My Comet, who is now known as European Gentleman, are capping the northern and northern west, and a decent position on this flag, with a lot of single rifles, building a lot of sandbags. Wow, he's in for the long haul shootout. Not sure if you want to do that versus a Germany sniper coming out very soon. Here you go. Here is an elite MG buy. Not going to do too well, in my opinion, versus the sandbag positioning. That may pin down these troops. Schotter now going to move up his few single guys. He's going to camp below that hill with that one single. And he's holding on. Center has lost with Nat capping it. Type 92 is finally going to end his adventure with a broken engine, and let's see. Oh no, he's gonna get this one tank crew out to have line of sight. It's reloading, and unfortunately he's died, but did spot this guy before he died. Allowed the Type 92 to take him out. As Jutska is now capping the mid-center. A very strange opening indeed. It's just weird. A very weird 3-1. Not a completely failed opening, I guess. They're holding on to flags, but I think European Gentlemen can quite easily take the advantage now with the numbers on all flags, especially on the left side. He's got such numbers on Schotter, but it just hasn't been pressing that advantage. Assault squad from Schotter coming in to meet. Look at that new skin camo by DMS, releasing a patch for, I guess, Origins and the new models, which unfortunately did break a lot of other things. Not sure about that, but I guess each to their own. Flamingo from Schotter. 80 rifle, unfortunately can't penetrate the front, it's like it looks. Framas with his one special point resistance, needs to get out his Panzerfaust and sneak up onto that looks. No, yep, he is right now. Now I'm gonna come out with the Panzerfaust. He's running though. Needs to be gone. Yep, he's going to sneak now. As Schotter is probably noticing, is now going back to the safety. Type 92 been taken out, though reinforced by an assault squad. He's going to push Nat off, and it is a 5-2 lead so far to European Gentlemen. Numbers are definitely in Catch My End's favour on the axis on that side. So center as well is being contested. This is a very confusing game. Really, no one has a good foothold, and it just seems to be swinging every single point at this stage. Framas doing well, takes out the elite MG Panzerfaust from Schotter. will take out the engine. Can it take out... Oh, it's taken out quite a few before it perishes, though it can be repaired. Return the stolen German half-track to the Axis forces. Shadow Mikering well on this side has manages to take it up, take it from Famas as the center. Jutska still holding on whilst on the northern west. Natnath will try an assault. So just keeping updated, guys, this might be the last tournament ever on Assault Squad 2. It's been, I'm pretty much tired of it, especially all these crashes and problems. And it's getting pretty old, so I think maybe the next one might be on Soldiers, Heroes of World War 2, whenever that comes out, if. Or, what's the other one called? Gates of Hell from Kill, as that comes out. So, we'll see how this goes. Maybe a break is what we need, but right now, the competitive community is an all-time low in terms of game time. And that's fair enough, it's been around for so long. Though it isn't fair enough that there is this many crashes, so I'm just frustrated, I don't want to cast. Actually, it's totally ruined my day, those two crashes, plus I've watched two replays that haven't finished, that must had problems. So I'll stop the complaining, get back into the game, and this Hushkus is out. Guess you guys don't know, don't know all the issues that happen after the cast that gets posted, but there is plenty. Hushkus! Moving up, down from the hill, now going to protect the flanks as Schott is moving up his infantry to pressure. Framaz lacking the infantry support, Hushkus forced to move away. It's going to come back later after this squad comes in to help with some line of sight. Schott also sending his guys building low that hill on the side. The pressure is definitely on. A Chihi from Jutska was meant for the Hushkus. Hushkus is in safety now. Looks like that's a guard sniper from Framaz. Sent one to the other end. Looks like Natnat and Framaz have split that squad. Shock infantry from Nat. Flamer doing well to kill the guys below that hill. And should be able to cap it back. Sniper will be able to now pick off these MGs from the home guard. Holding quite strong, Natnat. Framaz on the other end, forced to play in the backfield a bit more, and oh, this is what is good about sending your troops off frontally. It nearly takes out the entire squad right there. Three guys remaining. Just two guys in ambush. Chihi running back for some reason. I think something else is coming. Yep, here's the 57 from Natnat. So I don't recall if I actually updated you on this matchup. So this game, these two teams in the semifinals have played six games already. Seven games, and they're four games up, four games to catch my end, and three games to two European gentlemen. So it's been a very close series of the first to win two. And in this game, it's the eighth one, though catch my end did win the last one, so that means I just need to win one more to win this series. Framaz moving his Hushkus up to support a bit more. Veteran sniper from Schotter. And that sandbag. I don't see the sniper from Framaz. He must have been killed by the other veteran sniper. Gee, some nice HE shell damages from afar. Quite amazed how he does that. Always struggle to kill units with HE. Framaz 1 SMG does decent. Oh, does very well to throw that grenade, but does perish. Center held by Jutska, quite strong. And now Jutska is pressuring with the SNLF on the side flags. Now in a bit of trouble. European gentlemen, 6-25. Top 92 rush, I think, kind of slowed down catch my end, but they're now back into a dominant position with just pushing up the infantry. So what the hell was that grenade? Didn't do shit. Seen that a lot recently with the terrain glitch. Some terrain has problems, but I don't know, since the latest patch has been happening a lot more. Chihi moving to the left. Just trying to avoid the T-57 at all costs, but also trying to prove useful in another location on the map. 81mm, MLE 27 mortar, now panning away on the center, struggling to get anything. Jutska, shot. Oh, what's that? What's this guy doing? What does he think he's doing? What does he think he's doing? Not sure. 57, still playing a very defensive role, waiting for something to counter. Now Chihi, you can't counter it, so far away, and the Chihi had a very nice approach on his side. Oh wow, takes out that AT guy, I believe it was AT guy, in one shot. HE shell clutch. I think it doesn't have a shot to take out that Hotchkiss. 57 now going to relocate, see it on the mini-map. No, that's a T-7. What, T-70? What would you get T-70? Interesting buy. Framemaster, did you pick up that AT? I think he did. Going, okay, that's Shotter, picks up the PF. Can he escape? Yep, he's going to run into the safety of this barn. Framemaster. This SMB guy will be spotted by that squad. And almost a 5-cap now with Jutsko winning the center mid and also the right. Here comes the T-60. So that's a T-60, not T-70. I thought the turret was actually bigger. Sneaky S on the left from Jutsuka. T-60 luckily decides to move behind the crate. And that Nat will reach out the cappers and does so very nicely. Hold onto his flag. Is the A-Team G is spotted. Nat trying to root him out. One last grenade. Oh no, SMG to the back. Boom boom boom. Fells and gets don't know what you call it. There's no such thing as cremated, or like, what's the cremated of water? I guess a drowning, drowning funeral. Becomes the drown Japanese god. Chihi coming out to the right. Take out the T-60, 57 following in pursuit. Both of them decide to stop. Chihi gonna move. T-57's reacting to, I guess, waiting for it to, I guess it's stopping it as well. So the T-60 can reign supreme onto the right side. That doesn't matter because the majority cap is still on the axis on this front. Maybe the Hotchkiss can now come out to play once again. It has. It's at the top of the hill right there. And now it's going to come to assault the center. Here comes the Hotchkiss now, firing onto the enemy. And the 42 guy manages to not get hit. Sniper, I think. That's over here. Nearly down. Oh wow. Mortar, talk about you got a bigger, this is not a knife, this is a knife. 150mm 97. Definitely bigger than the French variety and can take out the Hotchkiss. Chihi has been felled, I think, by the 57. I believe it was trying to rush on this side. 57 took a pop shot. Took it out, hasn't finished it off though. I guess because the Hetzer's out for Jutsuka. And now 57 is kind of hiding. Or perhaps we'll see a 50-50. Here comes for a shot. No. Misses. Oh, what a shot from the Chihi. Bounces. 57 not taking a shot. Here comes another one. Misses. Hetzer for a shot. Oh. There go. It's track. No, it's not. Oh, Nimble Warfare takes out the Hotchkiss. Interesting buy there from Shotter. Oh, 47 MLEs down too. Very interesting buy indeed. And now the center has been decapped. 6-47. 13 minutes in. See 57 go out again for a duel with the Hetzer. Oh, it's decrewed the 57. And now Jessica can stay out, just constantly shooting it till it does something to it. It's taking out the turret, I believe, as well. This guy has free reign to finish it off. Moving closer for maybe a better shot. And I think that's yep, it's taken out. It still can be repaired. Jessica doesn't care. It's going to just move away for now. As he is capping the center as well. GPF, oh, takes out the mortar, nice counter indeed. GPF, three special points from France. And does, what a lucky shot, but yeah, I guess Shotter has bought, the Axis have bought a lot of emplacements which can be countered. GPF is the perfect buy right now. It's actually a problem for the Axis laid down in the track, later down in the game. Relocation from that sniper. Try it. Take out those paratroopers, SNLFs, or not paratroopers, the SNLF soldiers on that sandbag. Two MDs, juicy targets to hit. Center being assaulted now by Fremaz assault squad. Few SNLF holding. And it looks like they'll do quite well. Two MGs, Fremaz has sneaked one guy in, may get a mass grenade off. Evaded by Jitska. Reinforcements also coming in, partisans, recruits. Will do good as a meat shield for those machine gunners. And I think Jitska is in level win the day here, despite the superior skills and firepower of those two machine gunners. He'll cap that. Hold on to the point and hold on to the lead, 53-6. European gentlemen are struggling to get a foothold into this game. After that, after a bad start from Catch My End, Flamethrower not being able to get a good shot. Nat with a very nice gun. No, not really. Very, very short indeed. As the Southern East is now being capped by Fremaz. Try stop the point sticking to Catch My End. They cap that one and cap the side. Probably not. It's out of fuel. Shot a force to refuel this Chihi for its adventures up and down the map, supporting, trying to take the T-60 and evading the 57. And, ooh, fire special point tug. Interesting buy from Fremaz. There's, guess I've told this story before. Prototype tank. A few were built. No, they weren't built. They were designed to be built. After they were meant to be deployed after Dunkirk, but with Dunkirk didn't have. Oh, what a shot in the Hetzer! One shot, flame the engine, takes it out, and that's going to be pleased about that. It's Fremaz now, has the biggest tank in the field. They were meant to be deployed in France to fight the heavier German, to fight the German tanks. I'd say at that stage the King Germans had very, very light tanks compared to the Matildas and to the French Renaults and Chars. Another heavy tank to be useful, I guess, if that was the case. But after that, they focused everything onto the air battle, the Battle of Britain. So no need for the tank warfare. Tug now sitting into the center. Very slow. not being able to support too well. But I guess the Hushkiss now is out to support the center. Mortars down, can't counter this Hotchkiss. Nebel though isn't. Definitely going to be the priority for that GPF. I think it's a bit too far though to take out that Nebel. And it can't move once it's built. So I think that Nebel is going to be safe. Interesting shot on there. 6-67, hasn't managed to tick up yet. Jitska is pressuring the northern center point well. Top moving to the right. What's it targeting? It's going to try and take out the Chihi. Supported by Red Guard squad. Not too bad, I guess. So it's going to be the SNLF versus the Red Guard. The SNLF does have the position of ambush. Tog definitely being used very safely behind that barn. That Red Guard. So they'll get the better weaponry. We're taking out the majority of SNLF who dare to peek out into a shootout. A few guys in hidden positions behind buildings or inside the buildings. Chihi now relocating. Tug has powerless to do anything. And wow, that Nibbleworth a shot. Missed that, but that took out an entire resistance squad. Just a resistance squad though. Not too much of a burden. Fremaz relocating his Hotchkiss, gonna may potentially assault this point. Just seems like the infantry flow is a lot better for Catch My End. European gentleman hasn't had much luck in really securing the flags just by number. I think on the kill count they'll be doing okay. Yeah, they are matching it exactly. Look at the score. They've pretty much been matching it kill by kill. Catch my end. But flag by flag, they're definitely struggling. Wow, that grenade. Some left absorbs it. Another hit. Boom. I wonder if there's been a change in the latest patch where grenades, you know, don't kill shit that easily. Don't know. Okay. Normal Tiger from Shotter. And there goes the Tog superiority. Now that Tog is going to be quite a useless buy. Tiger, you know, very weird position too. In a position where it's not in the open, not being able to cover as much. Gee, he's felled by Nat Nat, but can't be finished off. So, tracked in the awkward position. Finishes off to 57 being repaired. 47 mil for a close shot. Fremez. Another grenade doesn't hit. Hits and doesn't do anything. Oh no. One of those glitches where if you hit the same spot that's been damaged, nothing happens to it and makes it really hard to kill. No, the 47 mil does finish it off. Tiger moving back. 79 to 8. They are capping. Oh no, not anymore. So still going to tick up to catch my end. They have got a bit of points though since. I guess now they're ticking up because catch my end is capping the flag back. 9 to 79. Jutska holding on with the flamethrower. So, while that's happening, just update you on the other side of the bracket, the lower bracket. We had Lobo and Lobo play like a sir. The replays unfortunately are broken. I did try cast replays from different people from that match and also different games multiple times, but they were pretty much bugged, so I couldn't upload it. But like a sir, did beat Lobo and Lobo, and I'm going to play on Team North in lower bracket round 3, and the winner of that will play Kangaroo and Wallaby, which is me and Hansy, in the lower bracket semi-finals. And then we'll play the loser of this game for the lower bracket final, which looks like to be European Gentleman at this stage. A 5 cap almost on. Another mortar from Jutska back here, and a very nicely placed one. I think it's out of the range of the 150mm howitzer as well, preventing any sort of assault down the center point. Fremaz gonna venture with just one guy. Wise thing to do. It's gonna take him a long time to make impact. Mortar shell hits on the side. Same time, Fremaz taking advantage of this flag. Just go home guard. Interesting skins, I must say. See, all the skins have changed for the default. It screwed up all the mods, but apparently now they're all HD. I personally don't really care. Wonder if you know the difference. It does look a bit more detailed, I think. Two to two out. Now here comes a Tog and Tiger battle. Let's have a look at this beast versus beast. A very old 1941 beast. I guess the Tiger's not that new either. 1942, I guess. I'm not sure. Oh, boom! Frontally facing. Wrecked. Tug 2, no chance. Unless it was a bit closer. Mortar now can't target. Oh, Nibble. Prevent any cap in the center. Most of the shells missing though. Doesn't take out the 47 either. T60. Oh, gets taken out through the wreckage. I never noticed that. I think the wreckage changes each game. That's interesting. One time I casted this game, it was ISU 152. So that's a Sherman and that's a fuel tank. Interesting. Changes. I'm gonna... Oh, maybe not. Sorry. There it is. There's the ISU 152. The other side of the map. Spastic. Bad memory. Old man. The old man tendencies are coming in to play. Definitely one of the one of the joys of being a YouTube caster, I guess. You get to see me grow old and become senile. But since NA's too, maybe at the end of his days, I'm going to be gameless very soon, so you probably won't see me for much longer casting videos until the next game comes along, which I really enjoy. I don't cast for money, obviously, just for love of the game. So if I can't find a community that I love or enjoy, there'll be no more casts. But yeah, I'm going to play. I've been playing Cossacks every now and then casually. I might upload a few games of that as well. But here you go, semi-finals, upper bracket. They're in the grand finals now. Catch my end, Jutka and Shutter, the superior team of the tournament so far. And NatNat and Fremaz will play the winner of Kangaroo and Wallaby versus Team North or Lycosa. Good game.